Hello and welcome to the 12th issue of Chaos Tube News. This is the final result of Dr. Weisenheimer's hair growing cream. I quite like it, but Dr. Weisenheimer complains that we look too much alike now and people could confuse us. I don't see how that could happen, but to make him happy, I'm going to cut it off for the next show. And I'm proud to announce the 7th annual Fractal Art Competition. We invite you to compete in 3 different sections and contribute up to 3 entries each in each section. In the still frame section, anything fractal related goes, 2D or 3D. In last year's film section, only films longer than 5 minutes were allowed. This year, the films have to be shorter than 5 minutes, but a competition intro is required. And the third section continues with last year's idea resemblance. The goal is to resemble a living object like a plant or an animal. For example, a fern or last year's axolotl. It might be helpful to check out Carly's axolotl script from last year in Dr. Weisenheimer's tutorial. Its huge parameter space contains surely more animals than just an axolotl. The most fun you gain by playing with the parameters that make up the fractal for the head and the body. As every year, the submission period lasts 1 month, starting on 1st of May. Your submissions have to be in the forum's gallery due to the voting system. The voting will then take place during the month of June. And the registration for the Fractal Art Symposium closes end of April 2014. Many outstanding fractal artists and forums members gather to share their experience. And the administrator, Christian, booked his flight already. He will contribute a talk about hybrid fractals. What are you expecting from this symposium?
I expect to create a real-life interactive experience for the fractal art community. An opportunity for fractal artists worldwide to connect on a non-virtual level. Also with live presentations, workshops, roundtable discussions, but also a vacation in a beautiful city with others that share a passion for fractal art.
This is going to be a very nice occasion. And Chaotica, a decent flame fractal editor, brings in version 1.5, a new animation editor with motion blur and a general improved transformation editor. Jay Wildfire, another flame fractal editor, provides in version 1.5, besides a reworked user interface, a new random animation generator, and the possibility to smoothly morph different flame fractals. And Mandelbalber is under heavy development as well, and Christoph Marczak just started to develop version 2 of it, providing full GPU support, user-editable formulas, and a full rework of hybrid fractal generation. Fantastic software just gets more fantastic. And good old Dr. Weisenheimer does not only invent incredible hair-growing cream. He started his Mandelbrot tutorial in reverse, with a visualization of the classic Mandelbrot iteration. He's still working on this, and more parts of the 4-part tutorial are going to follow soon. The scaling is performed by squaring the distance to zero of the individual points. Points inside the unit circle become dragged to the center. Points outside the unit circle move away from the center. The farther away, the faster the movement in an exponential relation. Here it is nicely visible that points below 1 move towards the center, and points above 1 move farther away. The scaling along the unit circle is exactly 1. Hence, these points on the unit circle do not move. The rotation from a different angle. The translation. Each point is moved individually by its starting location. The translation from a different angle. Isn't it marvelous? The translation from a different angle. I just can't get enough of it. Wow. And that's it for today. Oh, a breaking news. Let's see what it's all about. Has the holy 3D fractal grail been found the true 3D Mandelbrot? Let me check. Mandelbrot? No. It's about the perturbation theory. User Poldelbrot has optimized the recently implemented perturbation algorithm with perturbation theory to fight the glitches that occur when using the perturbation theory, and Colors Fractala program has already implemented it. And that's it for today. You see me next time. Thank you for watching.